Since we have all the coordinates of the games in an array, we can now use D3's mean function to compute the average. The D3 mean function, just like everything else we've been seeing, follows the exact same pattern where we pass it some array and some callback function, which defines the operation we want to perform. In this case, every element of coordinates gets passed to our callback function, and whatever we return from this callback function gets averaged by the D3 mean function and stored as a single value, in our case, in center x. And remember, the coordinates array represents the x and y coordinates returned from the projection function, which gets stored in an array where the first element represents the x value and the second element represents the y value. So our coordinates array is simply a bunch of xy pairs representing the pixel values where each game occurred. And by summing and then dividing by the total number of all the x values, we simply get the mean, which gets stored in center x. We can do exactly the same to find out the center y pixel value, to then return from our rollup function so we know the attendance to plot and the x and y to actually plot it at.